Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh. I welcome you to this session in Genetics and Molecular Biology lecture series. Up to this session, what we have covered? We have covered structure of nucleotides, nucleic acids including DNA, RNA and various other forms of RNA also, then replication, then transcription, translation, both post-transcriptional as well as post-translational mechanisms also. And now we are switching on to the next competency, that is BI 7.3, in which we are going to consider gene mutations and basic mechanism of regulation of gene expression. So in this today's session, we will discuss gene mutations. Now let us discuss what are gene mutations. So to understand gene mutation, we need to recapitulate the genetic code and structural classification of amino acid so as to understand the gene mutation properly. This is a genetic code. Now each triplet is a codon, and this codon is going to translate or code for a given amino acid, like UUU codes for phenylalanine. There are three stop codons, UAA, UAG and UGA. These are stop codons or nonsense codons or termination codons. Okay, why they are called as nonsense? Because the rest other are the sense codons. What do you mean by sense codon? Any codon which is going to translate into amino acid, or we can say if the codon is going to code for a given particular amino acid, that is called as a sense codon. Except these three nonsense codons, rest other are sense codons. AUG codes for methionine, that is the initiation codon or start codon. This set of four codons, ACU, ACC, ACA, ACG. So third nucleotide base is varying, but still this set of four codon is going to code for threonine. Here also this set is coding for proline. Here these two codon CAU, CAC is going to code for histidine. CAA, CAG codes for glutamine. Now let us see what is the classification of amino acid based on the structure. So amino acids are classified into hydrophilic, which are polar, and hydrophobic, which are non-polar. Then hydrophilic amino acids can be positively charged, negatively charged, uncharged or neutral. And if those are hydrophobic or non-polar, that can be aliphatic side chain amino acid or maybe aromatic side chain amino acid. If the polar amino acid is there and that is negatively charged, the examples are aspartic acid and glutamic acid. If it is positively charged, lysine, arginine, histidine, those are the basic amino acids. Okay, and aspartic acid and glutamic acid, these are acidic amino acids, those are negatively charged. If the amino acid is polar but it is neutral or uncharged, those are amino acids with hydroxylase group, that is serine and threonine. Then aspargine, glutamine, so amines of acidic amino acids, then cysteine and tyrosine. Amino acids which are coming under non-polar are aliphatic side chain or aromatic side chain. Under that aromatic side chain, we have phenylalanine and tryptophan. And under aliphatic side chain, we have glycine, alanine, valine, leucine, isoleucine, proline and methionine. So these are non-polar aliphatic side chain amino acids. So the reason behind understanding this classification and the genetic code at the same time is, if there is any mutation here in the codon, if the mutation is going to be a sense mutation, I mean that particular codon which is mutated is going to code for any given amino acid, the presence of that amino acid at the given sequence in a primary structure of a protein will decide whether the protein is going to be functional or non-functional, or it may be a partially functional protein also. So let's take an example here, sickle cell anemia, where glutamic acid is replaced by valine. Glutamic acid is polar and negatively charged amino acid, and here the valine is aliphatic side chain non-polar hydrophobic amino acid. So the function of the protein will be grossly affected, so that is partially accepted, not fully, right? So this was regarding gene mutation, for which we have revisited genetic code and the classification of amino acids based on the structure. Coming to mutations, it is just a replacement of nitrogen base with another in one or both strands, or addition or deletion of a base pair in a DNA molecule. It will result into a change in sequence of the nucleotides. The codon will be mutated and a different amino acid may be produced, or maybe it will result into termination codon and translation will stop. Then what are mutagens? Mutagens are the substances which can induce mutations, are collectively known as mutagens. These may be chemicals, may be radiations, or may be viruses also. Coming to the classification of mutations, so there are point mutations, there are frameshift mutations, deletions, insertions. Coming to the point mutation, it may be a transition or may be a transversion. And under transversion, we have silent mutation, missense mutation, and nonsense mutation. Under frameshift category, we have deletion type and insertion type. Under deletions, we may have a large gene deletions, maybe a deletion of a single codon or a deletion of single base. And under insertions, we may see a mutation with single base insertion, or maybe a trinucleotide expansions in case of Huntington's chorea, and duplications of the genetic sequences. Coming to point mutation, it is the replacement or changes in a single base. It can be of two types. We have seen it may be a transition, it may be a transversion. So what is transition? In this, a given purine base is changed to other purine only. Or if it is a pyrimidine, it is changed to other pyrimidine. If it is adenosine, it will be changed to guanine. If it is guanine, it will be changed adenosine. If it is cytosine, it will be changed to thymine. If it is thymine, it will be changed to. So these are transitions only, purine to purine and pyrimidine to pyrimidine changes there. Coming to transversions, the nucleotide are changing from purine to either of the two pyrimidines, or if it is pyrimidine present in the original sequence, so the mutated sequence may have either of the two purines. So this is transversion. Take an example, like if it is adenosine was the base present in original sequence, so it may change into cytosine or thymine. And if it is cytosine which was present in the original sequence, it will change to adenine or guanine. So these are the transversions. So the single base changes in mRNA may be silent mutation, may be missense mutation, or nonsense mutation. Coming to silent mutation, silent means there is no detectable effect, and the effect of the silent mutation is not seen because of degeneracy of the code. This is likely to occur if the change base in the mRNA molecule occur at the third nucleotide of a codon that we have seen under genetic code, and that is known as Wobbles phenomenon. And that's why the mutation is not translated. If there is wobbling and the changed new codon is going to code the same amino acid, so the mutation will be not detected at the protein level, but the sequencing method may detect it at DNA and mRNA levels. Taking examples of silent mutation, HB Sydney. If valine at B67 in adult hemoglobin is replaced by alanine, no change occurs in the functions of hemoglobin. The leucine is coded by CUU, CUC, CUA, and CUG. Thus, a mutation affecting the third nucleotide here may have no effect on translated protein due to Wobbles phenomenon. Then UCA codes for serine. If the third U is changed to A, UCA still codes for serine. We have seen this example when we discussed genetic code. There will be no detectable effect on such silence, on such silent mutations. Coming to missense mutation, a missense mutation or the effect occurs when a different amino acid is incorporated at the corresponding site in the protein molecule, and this mistaken amino acid or missense depends upon its location in the specific protein molecule, which might accept, partially accept, or may be unacceptable to functioning of that protein molecule. Mistaken amino acid is present in the specific protein molecule and depends on the quaternary structure also, where that amino acid is present, in the core or it is facing the exterior of the molecule. It will affect the protein function based on its position in the primary structure as well as where the amino acid is being placed in the quaternary structure also. It will decide whether it is acceptable, partially acceptable or unacceptable so far as the function of the protein molecule is considered. This missense mutation can have acceptable missense effect, partially acceptable and unacceptable missense effect. So coming to the acceptable missense mutation, here we have taken an example of adult hemoglobin beta chain. At 61st position, lysine is there and this lysine is replaced by asparagine. At the mRNA level, you can see the codon AAA or AAG is changed to AAU or AAC by transversion. Here, purine is changed to pyrimidine, so that is transversion. Okay, and protein level, lysine is changed to asparagine at 61st position in beta chain, producing HB hikari. So the replacement of a specific lysine here in beta chain, asparagine does not alter the normal function of hemoglobin in these individuals. Here in this example, the lysine is replaced by asparagine. So the positively charged amino acid is replaced by neutral amino acid, right? But both the amino acids are polar. So the polarity of the amino acid has prevented the mutation getting manifested phenotypically. This lysine is a positively charged polar amino acid. This asparagine is neutral amino acid, but both are polar amino acids. Because both the amino acids are polar, the mutation has not manifested phenotypically and hence it is an acceptable missense mutation. This is also called as conservative substitution. So HB hikari is an example of conservative substitution and acceptable missense mutation. Coming to partially acceptable missense mutation, a classical example which we take is the sickle cell beta globin mutation. This missense mutation produces hemoglobin S, that is sickle cell hemoglobin, which interfere with normal function of hemoglobin, resulting in sickle cell anemia in homozygous and sickle cell trait in heterozygous condition. Now see what kind of mutation is occurring at DNA level, at mRNA level and at protein level. In wild type or normal beta globin, the template strand, that is CTC, 3 prime to 5 prime is the template strand, the sequence is CTC. The thymine in this sequence is replaced by adenine, so it is transversion because pyrimidine is replaced by purine. This CTC sequence is converted to CAC, and at the mRNA level, the corresponding complementary base pair will be GAG. So in wild type it is GAG, but in mutated sickle cell beta globin mRNA it will be GUG. Because T is replaced by A, so it will have the corresponding uracil in the mRNA sequence. In wild type beta globin, the GAG, because it codes for glutamine, so the glutamine was present at B6 position. Because GAG codon codes for glutamic acid, the glutamic acid was present in wild type beta globin at 6th position in beta chain. But in case of sickle cell beta globin, the GUG mutated codon is going to code for valine at 6th position in beta chain of hemoglobin. Glutamic acid is replaced by valine. This glutamic acid is negatively charged acidic amino acid. It is replaced by valine. This is non-polar aliphatic amino acid. So the glutamic acid is polar negatively charged acidic amino acid and valine is non-polar aliphatic amino acid. So because there is a change in polarity, this mutation is partially manifested phenotypically. If both the genes are showing mutation, that is homozygous condition, so that is sickle cell anemia, and in heterozygous condition, one gene will be normal, another gene will show the mutation. So both will be produced adult hemoglobin as well as sickle cell hemoglobin. So this is partially acceptable because HBS can bind and release O2 although abnormally. So this is also a type of conservative substitution. Coming to unacceptable missense mutation, taking an example of HBM, in adult hemoglobin at 58th position of alpha chain, histidine is replaced by tyrosine and corresponding change at mRNA level is CAU to UAU or CAC to UAC. So histidine here is positively charged polar amino acid and tyrosine is neutral polar amino acid. But it depends on the position of the amino acid in a given primary structure as well as quaternary structure. And this is alpha chain and not the beta chain. Though both the amino acids are polar, the missense mutation is unacceptable because it produces non-functional hemoglobin. So this is a type of non-conservative substitution. Coming to nonsense mutation, the codon with the altered base may become one of the three termination codon. Because it is not coding, it is nonsense codon. If it codes, it is sense codon. This altered codon acts as a stop codon and causes termination of protein synthesis at that particular point because it is mutated into one of the three termination codons. And this will result in non-functioning protein molecule because number of amino acids will be reduced now in that particular protein structure. Take an example of nonsense mutation, beta thalassemia. A tyrosine which is coded by UAC may be mutated to a termination codon, either UAA or UAG. So this leads to premature termination of the protein and so functional activity may be destroyed. Taking another example, that is HB constant spring. A termination codon is altered into a coding codon or a sense codon. The mutation is UAA to CAA. So CAA codes for glutamine. So UAA, which was a stop codon, is now mutated to CAA and the glutamine will be produced. The protein synthesis will not stop because it is mutated to a sense codon. And this will result in elongation of the protein to produce run-on polypeptide. Means the translation process is supposed to stop after 100 codons, for example. So if the 100th codon is now mutated into a sense codon or a coding codon, it will continue translation process until the stop codon is found in the sequence. That is called as a run-on polypeptide. It may or may not have function depending on the protein structure. Coming to frame shift mutation of deletion type. The deletion of a single nucleotide from coding strand of a gene results in an altered reading frame in the mRNA. It is called as frame shift mutation. The machinery translating the mRNA does not recognize that the base is missing because we have seen it's a property of genetic code that there is no punctuation in the reading of codons. If a single nucleotide is removed, what will happen? The next nucleotide in the sequence will become a part of the mutated codon because there is no punctuation. Such an alteration in the reading frame results in a garbled translation of the mRNA distal to the single nucleotide deletion. If uracil is removed from this sequence, what will happen? The sequence of nucleotide forming triplets of codon is totally changed distal to the point of mutation. They may appear as nonsense codon on the way terminating the protein synthesis. The polypeptide chain produced is not only garbled but prematurely terminated, non-functional protein is produced. Coming to frame shift mutation insertion type. Insertion of one or two nucleotides into a gene results in an mRNA in which the reading frame is distorted. The same thing will happen if one nucleotide is added to the sequence. Distal to that point of mutation, the complete reading frame will be distorted and it will result in garbled amino acid sequences distal to the insertion. Because of the mutation of deletion or of insertion type, there may be a generation of nonsense codon at or distal to the insertion can lead to termination of the polypeptide chain, which may be non-functional prematurely terminated protein. Coming to the insertions, expansions and duplications, these are miscellaneous mutations which can occur. So single base addition leading to frame shift effect that we have discussed. There are trinucleotide expansions also, like in Huntington's chorea, the CAG repeats, the CAG trinucleotides are repeated 30 to 300 times. And this leads to polyglutamine repeat in the protein, because CAG codes for glutamine, and the severity of the disease is directly proportional to the number of repeats. From 30 to 300, as the number is increasing, it will increase the severity of the disease. So polyglutamine repeats in the protein, and CAG trinucleotide repeats in the mRNA will lead to manifestations of the disease. Then there are duplications also. The gene duplication may result from unequal crossing over of the chromosomes during meiosis process, right? This unequal crossing over of chromosomes during meiosis play an important role in evolution. This was regarding gene mutations. Refer to this literature for further studies. This was used for compilation. Thank you very much for watching the video. Please subscribe to the channel, hit like and share the video. Thank you so much. Keep learning, keep growing.